asking every player the same question.
All right.
Who's the best Fortnite player on the team?
Best Fortnite player? I don't know. That's a good one. I'm going to go with Kobe Ransom. Me? I don't play it. Like West play, but I don't really play it like that.
What do you play?
Call of Duty, Madden. I've been on Call of Duty a lot lately, though.
Okay, yeah, I was talking to somebody earlier. I think it was Kilton Anderson. He's a big call. I haven't played in a long time. I just didn't like the direction I was going.
So you didn't like the direction?
Yeah, like, it got all futuristic and stuff, and that's when I started playing Call of Duty.
Oh, yeah, but this one, the Modern Warfare 3, it went back to, like old. I don't want to say old, but, like, more old, more regular. It ain't. It wasn't like the Black Ops where they doing all the jumping and stuff. Yeah, it's regular now. But I don't know how the new Black Ops is gonna be though. They might have that. They might go back to the futuristic stuff with that one.
When Battlefield 1 came out, I kind of switched to that.
Mm-hmm.
I just thought it was a lot better.
I ain't never really played. I never really got into Battlefield.
From Battlefield 4 to Battlefield 1 was a big change. If you play Battlefield 1, It's just a lot.
Obviously, when you take over as an interim coach, coaching staff.
Do you play 2K?
I play a little bit. Not as much as all my roommates, but, you know, I ain't really that good at it, so. Yeah.
Because I was trying to get some my player ready. You have my player?
Nah.
That's the first.
Yeah, no. I've been saying I'm going to get me one. I've been saying I'm going to make one, but. Nah.
Who do you like to play as on 2K?
On 2K? I play with the Warriors because I like to shoot. So.
Very first person I talked today was a cheater, too.
Was a what?
Was a cheater, too.
I mean, I don't like the, what they got going on, but that's just who I play with just because I ain't that good. That's my, so I got to do that to try to give me some W's.
What's been you guys' focus? You know, you had that season last year, you changed coaches, and then you're getting a little bit of hype, but how you guys, what's the goal? What are you guys working on?
Really the ultimate goal is just trying to take everything day by day and making sure we're taking it one day at a time, so we make sure we're crisp on everything, you know. We don't want to jump to conclusions and keep looking forward to the future when we're not taking care of what's right in front of us right now. So that's really the big thing, just taking it one day at a time.
If y'all were on NCAA, which one of you two would have the higher rating?
Higher rating?
Yeah.
Probably him. Probably Wish. I mean, yeah, he'll probably have a higher rating, but, like, my speed would be higher. A lot of my stuff would be, you know, the ratings that everybody want to be high, mine would be higher than his, but he'll probably have the better overall. In my opinion.
Who's a better cook?
Him.
That was quick.
Yeah, him. He do most of the cooking. Well, all the cooking. So. Me.
Is it because he can't dance or you just that much better?
I'm probably say because he can't dance. I mean, I ain't the best dancer, but, you know.
Well, I'm bringing all this to him.
All right, bet. Appreciate it. I'm good. How you doing?
Hey, I'm Paul Litlow. I write for the ULM website, and I'm just kind of getting some opposing views on the Warhawks. You guys.
We didn't play Monroe last year. We played him the year before.
Y'all on the schedule this year, though, right?
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah, we got it.
Is that game, that ought to be back in line.
I'm not sure. It should be. Yeah, I think it is.
Anyway, I don't know if you've even thought about those guys at all. Are you familiar with much about quarterback Marcus Green, the dude that had some turn touchdowns?
I'm familiar with Marcus, but that's really it. I mean, I haven't really, you know, got into them yet because, you know, we didn't play them last year, so kind of fell off with knowing what all they got and all of that, so.
I guess I don't want to put you at a disadvantage then if you hadn't looked at them. I was thinking y'all would play last year. What you think about the event overall? Pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. Happy to be here. It's a good experience. You know, I'm not too much into doing interviews and stuff, so it's good for me to come here and be able to get some good practice doing all this.
Gives you some one-on-one kind of interviews, and it gives you some of those, you know, up in the...
Yeah.
That's what you guys, you know, aspire to anyway sometimes. I mean, not necessarily getting attention, but that's good for you. It's good for your life. Mm-hmm. Once you're done with football, you still got to talk to somebody and
yes, sir.
Communicate. So. Anyway, like I said, I was thinking y'all played last year, so.
I got you.
We'll see you down the road.
Nice meeting.
Thank you, man.
What's going on? Josh Moore.
You a senior and you didn't play last year?
Huh?
You a senior and you didn't play last year?
I played. I had got hurt early. Yeah, I broke my fibula, and that, like, set me back.
So what's the recovery process like?
Well, me personally, mine was, like, sped up. Cause I wanted to play. I could have took the chance to red shirt because I didn't play that much like at the beginning of the season when I got hurt. But I wanted to play. So fibula is usually like 6 weeks. I think I came back from mine. I broke it like that second week or the second game, and I was back. I was back like the fourth game, I want to say, third, fourth game. So really. Just, I had to overcome a lot of pain. You know, when I came back and I was playing, it was still hurting, but just having to push through, that was really the most with that.
Right.
And rehab and all of that.
How did your coach feel about that? Because I know some coaches would prefer for you to take that time and be healthy, but like.
I mean, at the time we had lost our first few games, so I mean all the coaches were like really on both sides of it, because one, they want me to be healthy, they're concerned about my health, and two, they still want to win. But the decision was really on me. They just put it on me like, okay, what you want to do? Because whatever I do, they was with me all the way 100%. So yeah, I really made the decision.
Did you consult anybody before you made the decision, or did you just know you wanted to come back ASAP?
I mean, I knew I didn't want to sit out, but it was still the thought of trying to be smart, you know, thinking the thought of, okay, what if I hurt it more, or what if I get hurt again and I waste a year? But I talked with my family over it, you know, all my brothers, my sisters, some of my cousins had a little input on it. But, I mean, for the most part, I had my mind made up, though. Mm-hmm. But they were still with me with it all.
Cousins always going to have something to say.
Yeah.
So were you nervous to come back?
Oh, first game back? Yeah. Because, I mean, I never broke a bone, you know, so I knew I had a whole broken bone in my leg and I was finna play. So, yeah, I was nervous, but I got through it.
So I completely missed that game. How did it go?
When I came back? I mean, we lost, but, I mean, I could say I did okay. I was a little shaky, but once I got in the groove of running on it, you know, I got through it. I was able to finish the game, so.
Okay, that's cool. Mm-hmm. Thanks for your time.
Appreciate it. Nice meeting
you. You too.
Go ahead. This is your beat. I don't know what you're doing.
How you doing?
What's going on?
Ryan Kostinski, I work for the Georgian.
Josh Moore.
So let me just get this started. So what can we expect from the defense this year? No, a little bit rough at times last year in the secondary, but they did well. What can we expect this year?
This year, okay, you know, we're running a 3-4.
Okay.
Really, you could expect us to be a disciplined, sound, fast, and physical defense, really. That's really to sum it up. Coach Sloan coming in with a good game plan with the 3-4. So I have real good confidence in what he brings to the table.
Talk about Coach Sloan coming in. How has the culture changed really since like all the new coaching staff came in?
I guess everybody's, you know, really buying in. I mean, everybody has it made up in their mind that we're not trying to go through what we went through the past 2 years. Like, everybody on the same boat, we're on the same page, so we can get it done this year.
Awesome. And has it been fun? How's the offseason, first offseason been with Coach Longo?
Oh, yes, of course. It's been real fun. The coaches try their best to put us in situations to where we can have fun, because if we're not having fun, then there's no way we could really get through this season how we want to. So, yeah, we've been having a lot of fun.
Awesome. Mike, thank you so much. I really appreciate your time.
Appreciate you.
Good luck this year.
Nice meeting you. So, point at the camera. You said what? All right, bet. So these the interviews I'm doing, or are they going to cut the camera on and stuff? Oh, it's on now. Oh.
But they'll cut some out.
Oh, okay.
No, it's being live broadcast into a stadium. No. Hey, I'm Bob at Kyrie.
Josh
Moore. Football Reddit. Pleasure to meet you.
You too.
So tell me about, yeah, obviously there's been a coaching change and it happened midway through the season, which isn't typical. What has it been like, at least in this offseason, now that, you know, obviously the staffing changes have been completed? What has the transition been like to Coach Lunsford's staff for you?
The transition has been real smooth so far. I feel like it made it better that we already know Coach Lunsford and he knows us. He knows what to expect out of us, and we know what we're going to get out of him.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like that made the process way better. And with the new staff, they came in, they're all on the same page, and they have a great game plan for us to get through this year.
So how did you get to meet Scott Sloan?
How did I get to meet him?
Yeah, Coach Sloan. How did you find out he was going to be the new defensive coordinator?
I feel like, when did I first hear? Coach Lunsford called me and told me. Yeah, and then a couple of days later, I had an opportunity to talk to Coach Sloan, and he talked to me about what he's bringing to the table, you know, what he expects out of me as a leader and everything.
Excellent. So obviously, I know being a D1 athlete is almost like a full-time job, but when do you get a chance to relax? How do you relax? What do you like to do?
On my free time, either I'm playing the game, my roommates will chill in the living room, you know, watch movies, watch TV, play the game together, take naps. That's really it with the little time.
Do you know what you'd like to do after football?
After football?
Yeah. I hope that's a long time from now.
I really don't know. I know you're supposed to have a plan B, but me personally, I'm trying to give my all to this right now because I won't have my athleticism forever, you know. So I just feel like I want to take that risk of giving my all to football, because I'd rather give my all to football than me focus on other stuff and then regret not giving my all to football. So right now I'm focused on football, but I still have. You know, lined up stuff with school to where when that time comes, I'll be okay.
Hey, you know what? When that time comes, you can give your all to whatever's next. You don't have to split it now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good luck, man.
Appreciate it. Nice meeting you.
Yeah, nice meeting you.
I was going to ask you a few questions, send it back to the station in Savannah. You know, what do you feel like you guys have improved on the most this offseason?
I feel like this offseason we've improved on our discipline. You know, as a defense, running around, creating turnovers, you know, and not giving up. Trying our best to work on our technique to where we're not giving up big plays, you know, because that's the biggest thing. We'll be having a good drive, and it's just one big play will sell us out, you know. So really just working on that.
How motivated is this group just to show that, you know, what happened last year, that's not Georgia Southern football? Do you guys have a standard?
It definitely puts a chip on our shoulder. Nobody wants to go 2-10. So really just having that hang over our head is just motivates us a lot, you know, try to come back, get a better season, try to get a Sun Belt title and go to a bowl game.
You know, guys are kind of doing all these off-season workouts, player run. How have those gone? I mean, what have you just noticed from them?
I feel like the player ran workouts are really good because it's just us, you know, and we have opportunity to try to line stuff up ourselves without the help of coaches, and that's good because we're on the field, the coaches aren't. through all the preparation, at the end of the day, once we step on the field, it's on us. You know, we get the call from the coaches, but we have to make sure we know what's going on. So I feel like the player-led practices help with that.
Last question, just how's the transition just gone from as a whole? You know, new coaches, new terminology, new philosophy, everything like that. How's it gone?
It's been going smooth, learning new defense and stuff. I'm kind of used to, you know, this my third defensive coordinator. So I'm kind of used to having to change and learn new plays and stuff. But I feel like it's been smooth because we know what we're going to get out of Lunsford since he's been here, and he knows what he's going to get out of us. So that really helps us.
Perfect. Good to go. Thank you so much for the time.
Nice meeting you.
Good luck this year.
Appreciate it.